Take us back to March 2009 when your doorbell rang. What happened?
I looked through the people and I saw Marzia with three guards. My mind was in shock. I just opened the door and they entered our apartment. They ransacked everywhere and they took both of us with all our belongings, like Bibles, books, Jesus movies, and everything that they had discovered in our apartment. And they transferred us to the security police.
For first day and especially the first week was so difficult for both of us because we were so scared. And they threatened us to physical torture. They told us that we will beat you until you vomit blood.
They sent both of us to a very small and dark and dirty cell in the basement. And every minute we were waiting for them to come and to take us for the physical torture. At that day, we were just we just hugged each other. We said goodbye. We were thinking that it was our last day on Earth.
You both could have been released at any time if you denied your faith. Why didn't you?
We are in love with Jesus, and we couldn't deny our faith. And also, because Jesus in the Bible says that if you wish to follow me, you must pick up your own cross and follow me. And so as a follower of Jesus, it was very important for us to pass through this test with victory. And also, it was an honor for both of us to suffer for our faith.
For 2 weeks, you were in detention, both of you, and then you were moved to the notorious Evan prison. What were the conditions like?
It's awful in Evan prison. For the first 14 days, we didn't have anything to eat. And even in public prison, we could eat just the bread and cheese that they gave to prisoners for breakfast. And that was all we could eat. And I was poisoned once because of the food. And, you know, the medical situation was even worse. There was just a small and dirty clinic, and we couldn't visit the doctor. For 9 months, we were both sick.
How did your faith help you keep your sanity while you were in prison?
Sometimes we couldn't pray in Farsi, our language. We couldn't find words because, you know, that situation is really scary, and our mind was in shock. And in those moments, we were just praying in tongues for each other. For example, when they took Marzia for interrogations, I was praying for her, and she did the same thing for me. And the Holy Spirit really led us in our prayers when we were praying in tongues.
We have many experience with Jesus. We had met him, taught his love, and had seen many miracles. And our personal relationship was very important.
You know, we both believe that Evin is really the heart and brute manifestation of the power of the Ayatollahs and is really the symbol of their dominance and strength over Iran. This prison is notorious for arresting, torturing, raping, and executing of many innocents.
Some of my friends, before I got arrested, they told me, Marzia, you know about Iranian prison and Iranian government, if they rape you in prison, if they torture you, what you will do. And I always, you know, I trust God, and I always told them that I'm sure that God will protect us, but if it happened, I'm sure that God has a reason for this.
At first, you all prayed to be released, but then your prayer changed. What happened?
We had many great opportunity to talk with many prisoners, and there were many prostitutes, addicted people, and they were most of them. They were so hopeless, sad, and disappointed. We had to pray and ask God to show us right person to talk to them. But in that prison, we had more opportunity to talk about Jesus with many women. And also about prostitutes, it was very difficult to find prostitutes in Iran because they are not in a specific place. But when we were in a prison, we find out that there are many prostitutes here, even madams. And we had a great opportunity to talk to them and pray with them. And some of them, they cry and they confess their sins. And it was really like a church for us. And every time, every day we gather and pray. And it was wonderful.
Wow. No wonder they released you.
Yeah.
We got to get these girls out of here, right?
Yeah. We were more free in prison to talk about Jesus.